How low in the scale of nature this law of battle descends, I know not. Male alligators have been described as fighting and bellowing and whirling around like Indians in a war dance. For the possession of females, of course. Male salmons have been seen fighting all day. Male staghorn beetles often bear wounds from the large mandibles of other males. The war is perhaps severest between the males of polygamous animals, and these seem oftenest provided with very special weapons. Charles Darwin, 1859.
People have always observed animals and wondered why they look the way they do. It's obvious how some structures are meant to function. However, other structures appear downright weird. In fact, eminent biologists, like Charles Darwin, were often just as puzzled. Animals have structures that come in a variety of shapes and sizes, and often are suited to perform a specific function. Some animals, however, seem to take this to the extreme. One of the characteristics of life is that it is organized at all levels. Animals are multicellular organisms that have specialized cells grouped into tissues. Combinations of certain tissues make up units called organs. The groups of organs that work together are called organ systems. The complementary relationship between anatomy and physiology is seen at each level. Here are a few examples of how certain structures that make up an animal's body plan are related to a specific function. Mule deer have ears that are very large to enhance their ability to hear. Female horseflies have mouthparts that are designed for ripping open flesh and lapping up the blood of the victim. Northern flickers have a slightly curved bill that make it easy for them to dig for ants and beetles. The gray wolf has a thick undercoat that is oily and waterproof, which provides good insulation against cold weather. Pronghorn have a large windpipe, heart, and lungs with an extremely light bone structure, which make it the fastest land mammal in the Western Hemisphere. Ravens have a beak shaped like a knife, which is used for tearing and carving. But then there are those animals with extreme and elaborate structures. Some male dung beetles have a large horn that they use to block entrances to underground tunnels containing females. Bull moose, bighorn rams, and elk have elaborate displays of antlers that can be used as weapons as they battle other males. All of these structures require an energy investment, since cells and tissues need energy for growth and maintenance. Even though the body plan of an animal is the result of millions of years of evolution, physical requirements limit what natural selection can do. For example, elephants do not fly because an animal that large, even if it had wings, could not generate enough lift to take off and fly. Also, there are only certain ways an aquatic organism can be shaped if it needs to be a fast swimmer. To understand animal structures, it is helpful to understand bioenergetics, which is the flow of energy through an animal. This flow of energy limits the animal's behavior, growth, and reproduction. It also determines the food requirements for the animal. Animals are heterotrophs and must obtain their chemical energy in food, which contains organic molecules synthesized by other organisms. After the food molecules are absorbed by the body cells, most are used to generate ATP by cellular respiration and fermentation. The chemical energy of ATP powers cellular work and enables cells, tissues, organs, and organ systems to perform many functions that keep an animal alive. The amount of energy an animal uses in a unit of time is called its metabolic rate, which can be determined in several ways. Metabolic rate can be measured by monitoring an animal's heat loss. It can also be measured by determining the amount of oxygen consumed or carbon dioxide produced. There are two bioenergetic strategies used by animals. Birds and mammals are mainly endothermic, which means they maintain their body temperature within a narrow range with heat generated by metabolism. Most fishes, amphibians, reptiles, and invertebrates are ectothermic, meaning they gain their heat mostly from external sources. Ectotherms require much less energy than is needed by endotherms because of the energy cost of heating or cooling an endothermic body. We have looked at ectotherms with elaborate structures like horseflies and dung beetles. We have also seen endotherms with large structures like moose and elk. One of biology's most intriguing and largely unanswered questions has to do with the relationship between body plans and metabolic rate. Every animal has a range of metabolic rates. Minimal rates power the basic functions that support life, such as cell maintenance, breathing, and heartbeat. For most animals, the majority of food is devoted to the production of ATP, and relatively little goes toward growth. However, for an animal with an extreme structure, there is an enormous investment towards the growth and maintenance of that structure. So why take the risk in having large, elaborate structures? Is there a needed function behind it, like fighting? Is it strictly for looks, so as to attract a mate? In a species of dung beetle, it has been shown that as more resources are allocated to building an elaborate horn, less resources are allocated to the growth of testes. This would seem counterproductive. Moose spend up to 50% of their food energy just growing antlers. Their own skeletons lose calcium and phosphorus to the building of these structures. This leaves their bones brittle and weak. So again, why do some animals grow large, elaborate structures? Why has natural selection not weeded out these animals that invest heavily into large structures? What other animals exist that invest in these same types of structures? Our story begins here, just off the coast of South Carolina.